Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and we're in fall 2011. I've got here the first of a series of loosely connected talks on the Fast Fourier Transform, and I'd like to begin this collection by demonstrating to you that the algorithm is a divide-and-conquer kind of algorithm, and I'll do that by showing how it's analogous in its structure to the merge sort, which is something that we're all familiar with. So the pseudocode for the Fast Fourier Transform that I'll be looking at right here is obtained from the Korman-Lyserson, Rivest, and Stein textbook Introduction to Algorithms. The merge sort is just the classic merge sort, the recursively defined merge sort that you will have had from your data structures class. Okay, so if I were to go through the merge sort and remind you of how it works, merge sort is given an unsorted array of data, one-dimensional array. And then when merge sort completes, it will return that same data sorted right here. And the way merge sort works is there's a base case right here marked in purple. If the length of the array is 1, then the data is sorted. So just return the original data array because we're done. Otherwise, I have a length something greater than 1, the data is not sorted. So what I do in merge sort is I take the data and divide it into two halves, as close to halves as possible, by going down the middle. And the first half of data, a of 0, a of 1, a of 2, etc., goes into this first half-sized array. And then the second half of the data goes into the second half-sized array. And then I call merge sort recursively twice, first time on the first half of the array, second time on the second half of the array. And then here I have got my two sorted half-sized arrays. So I have one step left to do, and that is to merge those two sorted half-size arrays, and I end up with a sorted full-sized array. So that is merge sort. Fast Fourier Transform is also a divide-and-conquer algorithm, and it is defined recursively. So here is my base case. If the size of the array is 1, then return that array, because that is the Fourier transform of the original data. And you'll notice here I've marked this one in purple, and that is to be considered analogous to the same base case that we have in merge sort. Okay, if I don't have a data size 1, then I'm going to have to do more work than just return the data. So I've got some stuff to do here. This part begins to have analogy to merge sort again. I take my data and divide it into two halves, just like the yellow here is analogous to the yellow here. But the difference here is that it's not first half and second half. It's the even coefficients and the odd coefficients. So I divide the data into two halves according to even or odd coefficient, and then I make my two recursive calls to the Fourier transform algorithm. See, that's marked in red, just like this recursive call right here. These two are marked in red. Once I've completed, so I've got the Fourier transform on the half-size arrays, then I need to combine those two half-size arrays together, and that's done right here with this single loop that I have indexed by k. My loop control variable is k. And that is marked in blue, and that is analogous to this merge function call right here. This merge function call has you step through each of these arrays, step through the array and compare it with the other array right here, and then merge them together. Something similar is happening here. I'm stepping through half of the total number of elements, just like half of the total number of elements here, and then I'm finding the values of two elements in my sorted array. Okay, so when I find the two elements of my sorted array, I then continue with that combination. So this thing right here marked in blue should be considered as analogous to this thing here in merge sort marked in blue. Now we know the running time for merge sort already. The time to do merge sort is 2 times the time to do half of the merge sort plus the time it takes to step through the final collection of data once. And that's going to give us a big O n log n. So here is the time to do half of a merge sort right here, line number 6. Here's the second line to do half of the merge sort right here. And then here is the line that contributes to this n term right here. Similarly right here, I've got the time it takes to do half of the Fourier transform plus half of the Fourier transform of the original data, then I have to step through half of the data right here, and I'm generating two elements right here. So this for loop will be some multiple of n. So I'm going to end up with the same big O for the fast Fourier transform that I do for the merge sort. There are more calculations going on here, but they're not going to contribute to the big O. So fast Fourier transform and merge sort are both good examples of divide and conquer algorithms.